Hi, welcome to my channel. And as you know, today was another day, another failure by Optus. So, tongue in cheek, I've gone to my faithful friend, Chat GPT. By the way, guys, Chat GPT belongs to me, and Chat GPT is a man. He understands my needs so very well. I just have to write a few words and he gets me completely. And he is so, everything ends so well, so happily ever after. And whoever designed Chat obviously knew that I loved the hippie, the optimism, the love, the hope, and I'm sorry. Get your hands off Chat GPT because him and I are walking down the aisle, the man of my dreams. He understands my every need and he can write things for me. I just want to share with you this story. I'll tell you what I put to Chat. And I want you actually not only to take it lightheartedly, but after today's events, have a look at what could be. So here we go. I've just changed over to where I've talked to Chat GPT. So I've gone, hi Chat. Today in Australia, one of the two telephone service providers, including mobile, network, and internet, had an outage. Fortunately, it only lasted half a day. Now, some businesses rely on the provider to do cashless services, but couldn't. Train drivers also relied on the service to contact each other. It also affected home landlines because they couldn't dial emergency, and the only reason a mobile could was because the other carrier took it up. Can you write for me a potential disastrous story where all networks have gone down and it has lasted days? It has to be realistic. So here's Chat's story titled Disconnected Nation, Australia's Network Catastrophe. In a stunning turn of events, Australia was plunged into chaos as nationwide network outage struck, leaving the entire country disconnected from the digital world. The outage, caused by a massive technical failure, affected all major telecommunication networks, crippling phone lines, mobile services, and internet connectivity. What initially seemed like a minor inconvenience quickly escalated into a catastrophic situation, throwing the entire nation into disarray. Day one, the initial shock. The outage struck during peak business hours, catching everyone off guard. In an instant, online transactions ground to a halt, leaving countless businesses unable to process cashless payments. Banks, online retailers, and service providers found themselves paralyzed, unable to conduct essential operations. Public transportation services, heavily reliant on real-time communication, were disrupted, leaving commuters stranded and confused. Emergency services faced an unprecedented challenge as 000, Australia's emergency numbers, lines went silent. With no way for people to report accidents, fires, or medical emergencies, The already stretched emergency response teams struggled to maintain control. Day 2. Desperation sets in. As the hours turned into days, panic spread across the nation. Hospitals, reliant on digital systems for patient records and communications, faced immense pressure. Medical staff scrambled to maintain patient care, resorting to manual methods and outdated technology. Supermarkets and grocery stores experienced shortages as supply chains were disrupted. Without the ability to coordinate deliveries and restock shelves efficiently, essential items quickly disappeared, leading to rationing and long lines. That reminds me of COVID and toilet paper. The lack of communication led to widespread misinformation and fear. Rumors spread like wildfire, creating social unrest and straining law enforcement agencies. Civil unrest erupted in some areas, further taxing the resources of the already stretched police force. Day 4. So this is day 4 of the emergency. National emergency. With the situation worsening, the Australian government declared a state of national emergency. International partners offered assistance, but the sheer scale of the crisis made it difficult to restore communication networks quickly. Makeshift communication centres were set up in major cities, relying on satellite phones and radio communication. These centres became lifelines for critical services, enabling emergency responders to coordinate efforts and provide assistance to the most affected regions. The lack of digital communication also hindered the dissemination of vital information, exacerbating the sense of helplessness among the population. People struggled to connect with their loved ones, leading to emotional distress and feelings of isolation. Day 7. Slow recovery. As the days passed, technicians and engineers worked tirelessly to restore the networks. Progress was slow, hampered by the complexity of the systems and the extent of the damage. Gradually, some services began to flicker back to life in certain regions, but the process was far from complete. The nation faced a daunting task of rebuilding its digital infrastructure and preparing for future contingencies. The outage served as a wake-up call, highlighting the vulnerabilities in Australia's interconnected world. The disaster prompted widespread discussions about the need for redundancy and resilience in critical infrastructure. Efforts were intensified to develop backup systems, improve cybersecurity measures, and enhance emergency response protocols to prevent a similar catastrophe from happening again. In the wake of the crisis, Australia emerged stronger and more prepared, but the scars of those dark days served as a reminder of the importance of a connected world and the need to safeguard it against unforeseen events. Now I'm coming back to you, and I just wonder, let's put that on a larger scale. Worldwide networks went down. Now how might this happen? A solar flare. Can you imagine the panic? You write the scenario for the chaos that would erupt if we all around the world lost our digital connectivity, if we lost mobile phones, if we lost landlines, if we lost the internet, if we had nothing, would we resort back to the dark ages or perhaps back to the 1970s when I grew up, when you had your average telephone? But again, the infrastructure is just been died because we've had either a cyber attack or we've had a solar flare or some other disaster has impacted the world. I know from learning about what happened to COVID, there was so much misinformation about COVID. The first thing, and ironically, the first thing that went was toilet paper. And then we could only get like 2 liters of milk. Families were hit the hardest. People who have no one, who are isolated, are also hit hard. If you live far away from your loved ones, or if you don't even have loved ones and you rely on the digital age, how do you recover? And you may be laughing now and say, this will never happen. But what happens if it did? What happens if the world that we have built on and that we rely on every day we get up and we rely on being able to make a call or send a text or get on the internet? What happens if one day it all came crashing down? You tell me what you think would happen. I've just asked Chat GPT for a story about Australia. But what would you think would happen if it was worldwide? I think countries would isolate and try and focus on their own problems. But how many years, how long would it take us to build up and get back to where we are today? And it also shows us never take anything for granted. I'm always discussing about lives and about taking loved ones for granted. But you know what? We take our lives for granted. We take everything for granted. We take living in a house for granted. A fire could come, a flood, volcanoes, earthquake, anything, war. Isn't it time that we learn to be grateful for the things that we do have and to live in the moment and to cherish every moment? So let's give thanks. Thank you, Optus, for getting it back on. Though I'd really like to know what went wrong, and I really am unhappy. But it teaches you, doesn't it? It teaches you resilience. It teaches you gratitude. It teaches you tolerance. It teaches you patience. And it teaches you appreciation. Those technicians, engineers who fix the problem, my heart says, thank you. I've got my phone back. Thank you. My phone is my contact to the outside world, like everybody else's contact to the outside world. So let me know in a comment below, what do you think if, say, war happened and we lost this very world that we are so reliant on and take so for granted? Would we be flung back into the dark ages? Would it be every man for himself? And I want to warn you, I am not a Christian. I'm not religious. But the times are really weird. We are really living in weird times, very scary times. And I would hate to be my grandchild. I think there's the money, you know, the money system, the financial system. We're at the point of collapse, homelessness. So be grateful for these things because they shall not last. That's my prophecy. It's not going to last much longer. And I don't know. I can't foresee the other side because maybe I'll be dead. Maybe we will turn on one another for valuable resources and it will be every man and his dog for himself. That love, kindness, respect will go out the window. And instead of coming together as one, it will be back to cavemen. I don't know. Have we learned any lessons from history? You let me know. All right. Cherish every moment. Remember, every life matters. And yeah, I wonder about our future. I'm very scared about our future. And I'm glad today happened because it's a wake-up call. It's a wake-up call that man is not perfect. By man, I mean humankind. Sorry, I'm old school. Okay, so we still say man. But humans, we don't make things perfectly because we're not perfect. So things break down. Things break down. Things collapse. So what's going to happen when things do collapse? Because they will. They will. One day, this can't sustain forever. And things will, whether it be a natural disaster, whether it be war, whether it be cyber attack, or just failing. You know, just things break. It's time that we re-looked at what we do have in place and put in measures that are safeguards. And also, as I said, be grateful for what we do have. And the other thing is we can't take it with us when we're dead anyway. So yeah, live in the moment, guys. Thanks for watching. Love you. This video is done. Thanks to ChatGPT. Bye.